Editing RAW photos from your entry-level DSLR camera? This is the subject of this episode. What's up, guys? This is Jack Sputnik here, and I'm very excited to have you here in our studio because today I want to show you how to edit your RAW files. And this is super exciting because this is first step to improve your skills by far. And whatever your reason is to be here, if you want to sell your photos on stock photography website, if you want to shoot better photos for your Instagram, or if you want to enter professional photography world, you need to shoot RAW and you need to edit your photos. So today I want to show you some basics, how to improve your landscape and cityscape photography. In one of the last episodes, we took you to Carvoeiro, to a beautiful little town in South Portugal, and we took some shots with entry-level Canon DSLR camera, nothing really fancy, something you may already have on your shelf. And we used a kit lens, plastic fantastic as I call them, to shoot photos, the best photos you can shoot with kit lens when it comes to landscapes. And very important disclaimer is that today I will be using Lightroom, but you can use Camera Raw, which is basically pretty much the same thing, and I even prefer Camera Raw, but Lightroom seems to be more popular. And you can also use free software that is there to develop your RAW files, like RAW Therapy, for example. This is totally free. And you can use the same rules, same principles that I will be showing here in Lightroom, there in other types of software. So let's jump right into it. Let's see what's on my computer here, and I will show you how to transform this RAW file into a beautiful landscape. All right, so let's get started. So there you go. As you see, this is pretty flat and doesn't have much color into it, doesn't have much contrast. So let's start working on it. And the first thing I usually do with landscape photography in 99% of cases is I bring my shadows up and I bring my highlights down, which makes this photo lose even more contrast. But then we want to bring whites back. And there you go. Not too far, not to have like blown out highlights. And we want to bring our blacks down. Not too much, just right here. Okay, and it already looks way better. The other thing that I just can't look at is just like, ugh, I can't look at it, is the horizon. So we want to correct our horizon, straighten it. You see, it's not straight at all. Now it is straight. Enter. And it already looks way better. But of course, this is just the beginning of what we are going to do. Second thing I noticed is a little bit too cold, you know, the white balance here. So we want to slide this white balance slider a little bit to the right, but not too much, not too far, because of these cliffs here. They're already pretty yellow, pretty warm, and this was a beautiful sunlight this day. We had beautiful sunlight, so yeah, pretty much here. I'm happy with this white balance. The next thing we want to do is we want to get some pops, you know, like we want this photo to look more contrasty, to be more vibrant. So the other thing I like to do is I like to bring clarity up, not too much, not too much. We don't want to overdo, but you see what it does to our photo, yeah. So somewhere around here, I love it. And the haze, since we didn't have any haze that day, I like to bring it a little bit down to give this photo a little bit of brightness. You see, like a little bit of this lightness. And this is a trick not a lot of landscape photographers will show you, because they usually slide this slider the other direction, but I will show you how to make it look better later with the haze in negative value. Now, the other thing you want to do is put the vibrance up, and I prefer vibrance. Oh yeah, you see, it's getting there. I prefer vibrance over saturation because it's more destructive to our colors, to our picture. I will bring saturation a little bit up, but really not too much, maybe only like 1/4. Yeah, maybe vibrance a little bit down. And that's it, that's it. The other thing I love to do with every landscape photograph is to darken the sky and increase saturation of the sky. So we will use this filter here. Graduated filter here. We will slide it down here. And what we want to do is we want to darken our sky, but slightly bring the saturation up and maybe create a little bit of bluish color cast. So we click here on color, use preset color here. Yes, that's awesome. And you see, it looks really good. In future, I will also create like way more advanced tutorials about editing your photos, but today we want to use our curve a little bit here. So what I usually like to do is I like to bring my shadows down, you see? Okay, I like to bring lights up, but not too far because we are losing detail in highlights, and I want to bring our highlights back in their place so they are not blown out. As you see these white buildings here, these zones, we don't want them to be totally white. We want them to be almost white, but have a little bit of detail there so those photos will not be rejected for editing technique later by stock photography agencies, for example. But even if you want to prepare them for print or whatever is your reason, or Instagram, you don't want highlights to be blown out. This is something to avoid. And another thing I want to do, since I mentioned at the beginning of this tutorial that we were shooting with Plastic Fantastic lens, with kit lens, and they're pretty notorious for having a lot of chromatic aberrations, which you can see here. You see this color cast around these palm trees here in contrasty zones, contrast areas. So you want to remove chromatic aberration, and look what it does. Boom, you see? No chromatic aberration at all. So no problem, you can still use these kit lenses and have no worries if you shoot in RAW and you can remove it later. Then we want to enable profile corrections to remove vignetting and to make this photo perfectly straight and fine. So this is it when it comes to total basics, and it already looks great. And now the last thing I want to show you today in this tutorial to make it ready, to make it pop, to upload, for example, for stock agencies, to stock agencies, is to use this this tool, pencil or brush tool, that you can improve some areas, some zones of your pictures. So in this case, I want to brighten it a little bit, increase saturation. And you see, what I want to do is I want this ocean to be more vibrant, to get more of this greenish color. It was really amazing that day. The color of the water in this zone is just amazing. And look how better it looks. The other thing I did, I just moved this tint slider to the left to make it a little bit more green. And I moved temperature slider a little bit to the right to make it a little bit warmer. And we have saturation plus 10 here, and that's pretty much it. The other thing we can use this brush tool for is our foliage, our plants here. So you see they are getting a lot more vibrant colors, a lot more greenish color cast here, which we like. And here, maybe on the cliff, maybe a little bit of these palm trees here. All right, this looks really cool. So now we want to go back to our main screen. And the only thing I would still do a little bit, I would bring exposure a little bit slightly up, or just a little bit. And I would probably turn our highlights a little bit down and maybe darks a little bit down. I feel like we lack a little bit of contrast here. And that's ready. This is the basic editing of landscape and cityscape pictures. And now let's take a look at our before and after. With this simple step, we made such a huge difference. Look at that. This is before, and this is after. So guys, as you see, it doesn't take a lot of effort. It is not really that complicated to process your RAW files, and now you can just export it to JPEG. I usually export files to JPEG with least compression possible, so the value of compression is 12, so there's almost no compression there. And those photos are ready for Instagram, for stock photography website, or ready to be printed. If you're thinking seriously about prints, we will be for sure preparing tutorial in future, but this is our first step here. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you find it entertaining. If you did, please don't forget to leave thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. This will support our channel a lot. I'm super excited that our Jack Sputnik community is growing. I see more and more subscribers. We are trying to give you a lot of value in these tutorials to show you how to shoot photos, how to edit your photos, and in future we'll be preparing way more of those tutorials. This is Jack Sputnik from Jackson Photography, and see you guys in the next episode.